Hello, I'm Kenny, a curriculum developer here at Codecademy, and I'm here to show you how to use the Codecademy website. There's a lot of things to do on Codecademy. This video will teach you how to use the homepage, how to navigate to different materials, what's the difference between a path and a course, what makes up a course, how to complete a lesson, and how to complete a project. All right, after you've created your account and logged in, you'll be in our homepage, otherwise known as the Learn page. And this page, as you can tell, has a lot of information. Let's start first by exploring today. That's the current tab that we're in. I'm using a new account today and just started on our Introduction to JavaScript course. As you take more courses, you'll find that the Learn section populates with the latest course you've taken. The Practice section and the Apply section are for pro members. The Practice section will lead you to review cards to go over recent materials. The Apply section will suggest special projects called challenge projects to test your skills. There are other resources below, including starter kit materials and things that are new and noteworthy. Scrolling down further, you'll find links to join our online communities. When we scroll back up, see other tabs like My Courses and the Practice tab. The My Courses tab houses the courses that I've taken and any career path and skill paths that I've enrolled myself in. Currently, I've only started on the Introduction to JavaScript course. If I wanted to build a solid foundation for a career in tech, I would enroll in a career path. However, if I wanted to hone in on a specific skill to expand my abilities in a job, I would enroll in a skill path. Both are for pro members. Our last tab is the Practice tab. In the Practice tab, it houses our collection of challenge projects for pro members who want to create a project with less explicit steps. It gives our members a chance to test their knowledge and use their creativity. To see all the courses, click on Catalog. There's a way to filter by subject or by language, and if you want to browse everything, just scroll down. Otherwise, if you know exactly what you're looking for, use our search tool by clicking the magnifying glass. I'll try out the search feature by typing in JavaScript and pressing Enter. The results show me the names and types of content that match my search term. Since I want to return back to my course, I'll click on the second result. This leads me back to the Introduction to JavaScript course. Scrolling down, I see two tabs, Overview and Syllabus. Overview gives me some context about what this course is about. When I go to Syllabus, it breaks down the course into modules. You can think of modules as separate titled sections that each contain learning materials. For Introduction to JavaScript, it starts with the Introduction module and goes all the way down to the Request module. These modules are intended to be taken in order, but if you feel comfortable with a topic, you can skip around modules until you find one you have yet to learn. Let's say I know a little bit about JavaScript, and I've worked with conditionals before. Then I might check out the Functions module and see if it's right for me. In a module, we have various materials such as lessons, projects, quizzes, and articles. Some of these materials are for pro members. Let's first explore a lesson which contains multiple exercises. As mentioned before, lessons are made of multiple exercises, and I can check this by clicking on the hamburger menu on the bottom left. Notice that this particular lesson has 10 separate exercises, and they have to be taken in order. I'm on the first exercise, What is JavaScript? The exercise of a lesson can have different layouts depending on the material. On the left-hand side, I have a narrative, and on the right-hand side, I have an image. For this specific exercise, as I scroll down, I'll see instructions, but it's not going to have any steps for me to include any code. So for me to move on to the next exercise, I'm just going to click the next button. In the second exercise, I still have a narrative, but instead of an image, there's now a code editor and a terminal. After reading the narrative, I'll see the instructions for this exercise requires that I write code. To get a little bit more clarity and help, I can click the hint. Now I'm going to demonstrate what happens when I try to solve the first step incorrectly. I'll type in the code and click the run button. Notice that I got an error message. Well, for each step or instructions, there's a test to check to see if the code written is correct. If it's not correct, there's a message that pops up above the run button that tells me what I'm doing wrong. When I fix my code and run it, the step gets a green check mark. Ta-da! If I need more help, there's a Get Help button on the bottom right that lists some resources, including a few forum links that I can check out. There's also a solution tab that will give me the answer to the entire exercise. This option is for when I'm stuck and I couldn't find any resources to help me. But be warned, it does give the full code for the entire exercise, not just a single step. If you spot anything wrong with the exercise, leave a bug report. A more detailed bug report means that we'll have a better chance at fixing the problem. Once I get the solution to all the steps, I can move on to the next exercise. Since exercises build on top of each other, we're not able to skip around exercises. Aside from lessons, I'd also want to showcase some content for pro members. As you can see, I've upgraded my account to pro to access quizzes, projects, articles, among other things. Let's start first with quizzes. Quizzes contain multiple choice questions and fill in the code assessments that check just how much we've retained from the lesson. Each answer choice explains why it's correct or incorrect. Another pro feature is articles. Articles explain concepts not covered in the lesson. This specific article explains more about JavaScript's different versions. While articles provide more insight into a topic, they aren't necessary to completing the exercises in a lesson. Pro users can also take advantage of projects. Let's take a look at the Kelvin weather project. The goal of projects is to practice the concepts taught in the lesson. There are a few things to keep in mind for projects. Like exercises, the layout may differ depending on the material being taught in the lessons. One change you'll notice is that the button to execute our code now says save. They work very similarly, but there's no test that's actually being run in projects. So to pass a step, you simply have to click off the step and it gets marked as complete. If you get stuck, there are project walkthrough videos that can help you along in the Get Help section. You can also check out the forum if the video hasn't been made yet. For newer material, these videos might get added later on. Feel free to use the project to test your skills and stretch your creativity. Thanks for following along. When starting something new, one of the biggest steps is simply trying it out. With Codecademy, we have a platform that guides you along and teaches you how to code at your own pace. We hope this guide made it even a little easier to take that first step. From all of us at Codecademy, we wish you well and happy coding.